I recommended a guaranteed income in the end of work. Milton Friedman did it before I did. When technology displaces employment, there's two things you can do. Reduce the workforce or reduce the work week. For most of the history of the labor movement, the trade unions were always in support of reducing the work week because the idea was to have leisure and not just to have money. You know, Keynes, you mentioned Keynes, he wrote a little essay in 1930. Everyone ignored it. It was the Depression was going, people were depressed, the job of the Depression. He wrote a little essay saying, "A Letter to My Grandchildren." He said, "You're going to hear more and more about something called technology displacement. It's a new term. Many people are frightened of it. Where are the jobs going to go?" But he said, this could be the liberation for the human race. Because as we move further into the 20th century and the 21st century, the technologies can do the heavy lifting. It can liberate the human race so that we can get on with the more important business of life, our transcendence, our sense of mission, our journey here on this planet. Let the machines do all the work. And he said, it may be in my grandchildren's generation, we will reach that point. It may be his most poignant forecast, actually. I think that our kids, here's my bet. I suspect our grandchildren will look back on the 20th century where millions of people's whole life was dedicated to making widgets and accumulating a certain amount of material possessions, and they'll think, what a terrible way to value human life. They'll be as repugnant thinking about how people's life was wasted as we were when we look at slavery and serfdom, because they'll say, there's more meaningful things to do in life. Let the machines do all of the menial work so we can get on with using this wonderful social brain in our empathic circuitry to try to reintegrate into this beautiful planet we live in.